Okay, now that we have a basic sound and video setup, we can go and dig into the software a little bit. Now, this search bar here is going to be your best friend. This is where all of your music files will be located, no matter what folder that they're in. So we add everything to the basic search database. What we want to do now is look about what we're going to use in this software. You have four options right here: browser, sampler, effects, and recording. We're not going to use sampler, and we're not going to use recording. If we're going to record, we're going to do that a different way with this software. But browser is where your best friend, the search bar, is located. Effects has some various effects, about two or three that are useful for the karaoke aspect of this software. So again, if you never see your search bar and you're worried, where is it at, just simply click on browser and there it is again. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to search for a song, and I'm going to make a DJ list. So this is a DJ set list which you can save and go back to at any time and instantly play, so you're ready to have some background music before you start your karaoke show, because sometimes you might just not have enough karaoke singers ready, or you're just setting up and you want to get some background music in there. So I'm going to start typing in what I'm looking for. I want some Johnny Cash. Hurt's a good song. Now I know that it is a DJ song if it is this gray, because it's already been played, or yellow. So I'm going to take the song, click, drag, and drop it over here in the right-hand section. I'm just going to pull up another couple songs at random here. Elvis Presley, Life. Do an Elvis Costello. We'll just throw a couple more songs in there. Let's do the Cupid Shuffle. And Justin Timberlake, Can't Stop the Feeling. This list is ready to go. So what I want to do is play these songs one after another, so it automatically fades from one song to the next, starting at the top of the list, and then going down to the bottom of the list. If I click this gray button right here, it's a lightning bolt, and when it turns green, it will begin playing instantly. Now I know I'm good to walk away and get ready setting up the rest of the show when I see that there is two songs loaded here. So you can see these little gray lines represent BPMs, or beats per minute, and it will automatically end and go right into the next song, going all the way down. Now, if I want to save a playlist that I made, this little piece of paper with the down arrow here is my playlist management button. If I click on this, go down to save, and now I name it. I'm going to name this one test. This is just a test. And I hit OK. I can always find it now on the left-hand side of the screen here where it says playlist. By clicking on playlist, it will bring down a drop-down menu of all my saved playlists. In this case, I only have the test one, and I can click, and it will bring it all up here in the search criteria now. If I want to get out of that and search all my database, just click on this PC and reset it, and now I can search all my songs. To get rid of the playlist that you have in here, just click anywhere in any of the songs and highlight them, hold Control, and hit A. It highlights everything. Then I can simply just right-click and remove. To bring my playlist back up, I will click on the playlist that I want, which is Test. I can click in this playlist down here, hold Control, hit A, and drag the entire playlist over at once, into which it queues it up and it's ready to go again. All I have to do is hit play and walk away.
I hurt myself today.